Hi all. Now we are going to see about VLAN and DTP lab scenarios. This is the lab scenario that we are going to see, and this is the process that we are going to compute. Let's take a close look over here. First, what we have to do? We just want to create this VLANs, 5 VLANs in all the switches, and then do the process. Let's get into the VLAN configuration. First, I just log into the switch one. First, I'm going to configure the host name as switch one for this. That's it. And this is for switch two. Here. Switch two. And next to change the name for switch 3. And this is switch 3. Now what is the first step we need to do over here? First we need to create this 5 VLANs. First we configure a switch 1. Okay, first I'm going to the configure terminal mode. Next, in order to create a VLAN, just want to type VLAN under number 10 and want to give the name that I'm going to use here. I'm just copying it, pasting it here. VLAN 20. Name USA, VLAN 30, name New York, and then VLAN 40, name France, VLAN 50, and it's Netherland. This is what I'm going to configure in all other switches. That's totally 3 switches. In all other 3 switches, this is what we are going to configure. VLAN 10. Just copy it over here and paste it. Okay, I'm just copying and pasting it over here. Yep. Paste. Oh, this is switch one. Okay, already created. We need to configure the same thing in switch two and switch three. Go to switch two. Just right click and paste it. Switch 3. Okay, you can see that all VLANs 10, 20, 30, 40, 50 has been configured. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50 is configured. But the ports, there's no other ports has been assigned to this. Next step, configure FastG3 0/24 on switch 1 as an access port for VLAN 10. Okay. We just want to assign this port that is being connected to the host FastG3 0/24 as an access port for the VLAN number 10. First, we just want to enter into the interface class 330/24. We need to configure it an access port, switch port, more access. It creates as an access mode. Then switch port access VLAN. What VLAN we have to give? We need to give VLAN number 10. VLAN 10. We can just check this. Show VLAN. You can verify that VLAN 10 is being configured to the port number 24. Next, configure /0/24 for Switch2 as an access port for VLAN 20. Next, we just want to move to the Switch2. Here, the port number 24 is being connected to the host. Configure mode, interface /0/24, switch port mode, access, switch port, access. What we have to, we need to give a VLAN number 20 over here, not VLAN 10, it's a VLAN 20. Show, and verify by here. It is being configured to the VLAN number. Port number /0/24 is being configured for the VLAN 20 in switch 2. Next, we need to configure switch 3 as an access port for VLAN 10, /0/24. Go to switch 3, configure interface /0/24, switch port mode access. It will create this port as an access mode, and switch port access VLAN and 10. Switch port access VLAN 10. Okay, that's it. Show VLAN. It is being configured for the VLAN 10 for the port number /0/24. Okay, next. Link between switch 2 and switch 3 is not allowed to dynamically negotiate a trunking protocol. What this means is that we should either give a trunk or an access port. We should not use dynamic auto or dynamic desirable. That should not be used. We should only, that should be manually configured. It should, this port should either become an access or a trunk, should be manually configured by the user. The switch does not allow it. So this is what we just want to cancel the negotiation between switch 2 and switch 3. Okay. Between switch 2 and switch 3. Which is the port that is being connected to the switch and switch 3? You can just check it. Between switch 2 and switch 3, fast Ethernet 0/2. Yes, CDP. What this CDP enables to show us is that which are all the devices that is being directly connected. It will work only for the Cisco devices. This CDP Cisco Discovery Protocol. It will directly send a message and just receive the message which are all the Cisco devices that is being connected with certain details. If it's been router or switch or whatever is that, what is the series number, which port it is being connected, and what is the IP address if it has been configured. These details and all will be given by the CDP neighbors command. We are just logging into the configuration mode. Then we just want to put this, before going this, we just want to show interface /0/2 switch port. You can check this as negotiation of trunking is on over here. You can see this negotiation of trunking is on. So what we have to do, we just want to cancel this. How to cancel? Just look into it. Interface /0/2 switch port, no negotiate. See the conflict between no negotiate and dynamic status. Since it is dynamic auto, it has been, you can see with this configuration itself, it has been by default it is a dynamic auto. We just want to set it as either a trunk or an access port before we need to do this. So I'm just configuring it as a trunk port as it is between the switches. Switch port mode trunk. Okay. Then switch port negotiate. Now we can verify this configuration. Switch port. You can just check as negotiation of trunking is off, which means that we have to configure either as an access port or a trunk port. The switch will not dynamically decide to become access or a switch port for this particular interface. This is what it will do. Okay, the same configuration is to be done on this port, that is a switch 3 consent port. Which port it has been connected? Fast Ethernet 0/2. Show interface fast Ethernet 0/2. Switch port. Here the negotiation has been on. What we have to do is that just log into the interface. Switch port mode trunk. Switch port. Then we just want to stop the negotiate, no negotiate, and that's it. Show interface fast Ethernet 0/2 switch port. You can just check that negotiation of trunking is off. So we can confirm with this, the negotiation has been stopped. That is, if the switch will not become or will not choose as a trunk or access port by its own self. It is the user that is who has to configure either to become as an access or a trunk port. Okay, next. Only VLAN 1, 10 and 20 are allowed between switch 1 and switch 2. Okay, switch 1 and switch 2. Okay, we just want, this is switch 1. Which is, we need to configure a connection between switch 1 and switch 2. So the interface is fast Ethernet 0/1. We are entering into the interface configure mode. Then interface fast Ethernet 0/1. Since it is between the switches and we need to allow more than one VLAN, we are using it as a trunk port. Switch port mode trunk. Then we just want to allow switch. If you see now, show interface trunk, you can just see for the interface fast Ethernet 0/1. VLANs allowed on the trunk are 1 to 1005. That means all the VLANs are allowed over here. So what we need to do, only VLAN 1, 10 and 20, that is a native VLAN, and VLAN 10 and 20 are only to be allowed between the switch 1 and 2. This is what we need to change it right now. So for that we just want to go to fast Ethernet 0/1 consent interface and switch port trunk allowed VLAN none. We are just removing all the interface, all the VLANs for the particular interface. You can just check it now. Show interface trunk. So you can see there is no VLANs are being allowed. So we are just again configuring it. Switch port trunk allowed VLAN 1. 10 and 20. This 3 is being now allowed. You can just check it. Show interface one second. Interface fast within 0/1 switch port trunk allowed VLAN. We just want to add 10 and 20. through interface trunk. You can see that now the allowed VLANs are 10, 20 and 1. And it's using encapsulation type 802.1. Some of the switches will not use it as a default. What they will use is they will in the non-negotiate mode. So what we have to do is to keep this encapsulation mode in the interface so that it will become a .1Q, 802.1Q encapsulation trunking mode. And then we need to do the same configuration in other switch. This is a switch one, we need to do it in the switch two. Just check it, show interface trunk, all VLANs are allowed. Switch one, switch one is fast ethernet 0/1. So fast ethernet interface 0/1. Switch port mode trunk, switch port trunk, allowed VLAN, none. We are just removing it all the VLANs, and we are just add allowed VLAN 1, add 10 and 20. Show interface trunk. We can just check it. VLANs allowed on. Oh, this is the fast ethernet 0/2 port. Fast ethernet 0/1 port. You can just confirm it over here. Fast ethernet 0/1 is the one that is being connected to this. Fast ethernet 0/1 is the interface that is being connected over here. So we can confirm that switch 1 and switch 2 connectivity is being allowed by the VLAN 1, 10 and 20, not more than that. That's it. What about next? 10, 20 and 50 are allowed between switch 2 and switch 3. Now we need to check into switch 2 and switch 3. Switch 3, fast ethernet 0/, what are the VLANs that is being allowed? All the VLANs is being allowed. What we need to do is to limitize the same concept. Interface, fast ethernet 0/2. Switch port mode trunk, switch port trunk allowed VLAN, none. Switch port trunk allowed VLAN, add, what are the VLANs to be allowed? 10, 20 and 50. 10, 20 and 50. You can just verify that, show interface trunk. One is not allowed. Switch port trunk allowed VLAN, add one. That's it. You can just confirm. Show interface trunk. Yeah, it is allowed. Then we need to do the same configuration in the switch 3 too. Switch 3, show interface fast ethernet, just control, show CDP neighbors. Switch 2 is fast ethernet 0/2, show interface trunk 0/2 is with all the VLANs that has been allowed. Configure mode, interface fast ethernet 0/2, switch port mode trunk. Switch port trunk allowed VLAN, none. Allowed VLAN 1, add 10. Next, what are the other VLANs? 20 and 50. 10, 20 and 50. Show interface trunk. Show interface trunk. Okay, it has been allowed. So this, that's it. What is the next thing? The native VLAN between switch 1 and switch 3 should be VLAN 50. We need to configure a native VLAN between switch 2 and switch 3. Switch 2 and switch 3 or switch 1 and switch 3? Between switch 1 and switch 3. Okay. Just go on to switch 1. Show CDP neighbors. between switch 3. We need to configure native VLAN as 15 between switch 1 and switch 3. So these two are switches. Okay, interface patch Ethernet 0/2. Patch Ethernet 0/2. Switch port trunk native VLAN 50. Show interface patch Ethernet. Show interface trunk. Here it hasn't been changed. Show interface. Show interface patch Ethernet 0/2 switch port. Trunking native VLAN mode. Show interface trunk. You can check that still it is native VLAN 1 only here. Oh. What will be the issue? Means we just want, we haven't configured this as trunk. See here. It has been, is a trunk native VLAN we have given, but this interface is not in the trunk mode. That's the issue. You can just check it. Show interface fast Ethernet 0/2. Switch code. It is in dynamic auto static access. That's the issue. Interface fast Ethernet 0/2 switch port mode trunk. Okay, show interface trunk. The issue is that is not in the trunk, so it's not showing as an encapsulation. That's the issue. Now we can see that we have configured this as a trunk, and the fast Ethernet 0/2 is being considered to be as a native VLAN 15. Next, we have to do the same configuration at fast Ethernet 0/1 of switch 3. Interface fast Ethernet 0/1. It has been in 1. That is fast Ethernet 0/1 is in trunk. Is it in 1? We just want to do it. Switch port mode trunk. Switch port trunk native VLAN 50. Okay, you can just see the error. When we have just 1 second. See here, this is switch 1 and this is switch 3. You can see the error as, where is the native VLAN? Native VLAN mismatch. You can just check it over here. Native VLAN mismatch on the port number fast Ethernet 0/2. The VLAN that has been newly assigned is 50 with the switch 3. That is the host name of other end switch. This is the VLAN of this is the old VLAN. Which the VLAN that has been in the fast Ethernet 0/1. This is the error that has been showing. And once we have changed the VLAN of a switch 3, we can just see here, unblocking fast Ethernet 0/1 for the VLAN number 50. This is what it will show. What it's showing is that you are using a considered VLAN, but it is now being changed to other VLAN, so there is a mismatch of VLAN. We can't able to transmit any of things. That's what it's showing in the switch 1. And again, once I configure or change the native VLAN over here, that means both ends has to be the same native VLAN. In the switch 3, yeah, the issue gets over resolved, and now we can do whatever we want. That's what it's saying in switch 3. That's it about native VLAN. Then, assign IP address to the PC and try to reach switch 1 to switch 3 PC. You just want to assign an IP address to switch 1 and switch 3. Switch 1 and switch 3 and try to reach this 2N. 1 second, I already assigned, yeah. 192.168.1.10, which I have assigned over here. 1.30 is being assigned over here, both in the same segment. Just look. 1.20 is assigned over here. What we need to check over here is that show VLAN.
The fast rhythm is 0/, it belongs to VLAN 10.
Then here, switch.
This also belongs to the VLAN 10.
And what about this one?
Switch 2 is connected to the host with the VLAN 20.
So what we have to make sure is that the this PC that is being connected to the switch 1 of VLAN 10 should able to communicate with this same VLAN, VLAN 10 over here at switch 3. But switch 1 PC should not communicate with the switch 2 PC as they both in the different VLAN. Okay, let's try it out. It's been configured. Ping 192.168.1.30. It's pinging. Good. Then 1.20. This means this can reach this, but this can't. It was unable to reach this due to the VLAN error. Okay. We can also confirm from this end to. Can just keep it out. It's reaching at VLAN 20. Okay, how we can resolve this issue in the sense means we just want to change the VLAN number in the switch. Either we can change this consent port to VLAN 20 or this consent port to VLAN 10. We can just change it, means automatically they both can reach each other. And this is the way that we can resolve this issue. That's it. Thanks for watching. Until next time.